नामशिष्टं मनुमपि सचिकोत्समत्रस्वरूपम् रूपं तस्या व्रजवरिपुरीं माथुरीं गोष्ठवाटिं राधाकुण्डं गिरिवरमहो राधिका माधवासं प्राप्तो यस्य पतितकृपया श्रीगुरुं तं नतोऽस्मि वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायिने कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरवे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो गिरः कातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया कर्वो विनेजु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमान् कोऽस्ति त्वैवास्मि न जीवामि तया विना इति विज्ञाय
First of all, my humble obeisances, the Lord of the top nine, spiritual Guru Path Padma, Netarira Praveshtam Vishnu Pasismad Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. And in the lotus feet of my Siksha Guru, Netarila Pravishtam Vishnupad, Shishimad Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. In the morning I told that I come only fulfill the desire of my Gurudev and Siksha Gurudev especially. You know how wonderfully in couple of years Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj preached over the whole world, in mountains, in oceans, in far remote villages, everywhere in the whole world. And he wrote so many books, translated, authorized books, and he established species center here and there and establishing. Publishing books and distributing. Book distribution is also a part of bhakti. We should do what he did, we should try to follow, actually. But taking the essence of the books himself, ourselves, and then to preach others and to distribute. First you should test the nectar of the books. Now books, he wrote so many and everything is there. But even he was here in this world, he has written so many books, not a stopping. And that is why he kept some
remnants
for me that you should complete. And to fulfill their desires. Now, very authentic books are coming, like Gita Govinda, Bhajan Rahasya, Ujjwal Nilmani,
Bhakti
Rasamrita Sindhu,
Brihad
Bhagavatamrita. And after that, 10th canto of Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur explanation. If Krishna will give me life and on some His mercy.
Jaiva
Dharma. Okay. But you will have to help me. Swamiji, my Siksha Guru has given me so many qualified devotees, that they are helping so much, I cannot repay them. Shyam Rani helping in all this. Bhakti Shar Maharaj, Aranya Maharaj, Satyan Maharaj, Van Maharaj, Ashram Maharaj, Padmanabh, so many. About 100 computers are going on in my life. They are always engaged. Myself, 24 hours in writing books, and I am happy. And he is still preaching here, there, going, coming, meeting in so many devotees. I am very happy. Now, as I told in the morning, the aim and object of our life. And then, a process by which we can attain that. Not that first process and then object. No. As we have our aim and object of the life, then we'll have to proceed. How to attain this? And it will be by bhakti only. About more than 5,000 years before, in India, on the bank of Gomti River, Namisharanya, so many devotees, they were assembled at Namisharanya, and all were thinking, what to do? Very powerful.
Kali Yuga
is coming. And then every will do against their religious things, mind. Always be engaged in sense gratifications. And they will be bound to do all these things. To save from Kali Yuga prabhav.
Influence.
What should we do? In the meantime, Sutta Goswami came. Saunakadi, 88,000 devotees came there, assembled at a one. No computer, no
internet, microphone.
Internet. Nothing was there.
No sound system.
No telephone. Nothing was there. And how they were collected. Very wonderful. And then they gave proper honor to Sutta Goswami. Who is Sutta Goswami?
Two
Goswami Sutta. Second Sutta Goswami, who was the disciple of Srila Sukadeva Goswami. And they asked, what should we do? And then, he told, Prayena Alpayavusa Sabya Klavasin Yuge Jana Manda Sumanda Mathe Manda Bhagya Upatita Prayena Alpayavusa. In the time of Satyayuga, the age of general persons was not less than 1 lakh years, sometimes more. And in Theta reduced 15,000 years or like that. And after that, in Dwapar, 100 or more than something. And in Kali Yuga, even not 100 years. So prayena alpa ayusha, very, very small age.
Short lifespan.
Their life is very
short.
Short. Manda, Their intelligence is very dull. Sumanta Matayo. They are engaged in sense prophetic gratification and other things. Always. In bad activities. Eating what? Meat.
Fishes.
Fishes.
Eggs.
Especially
beep,
fishes.
Especially
fishes. I see that all one, even cats I have seen, they are taking
fishes.
And all the birds, they sit very like a gentleman on one leg. And when they will see any fish, off. All likes. Western civilization depends on this. Manda bhagya, they will do for good, but it will come, the result will come what?
Unlucky.
Opposite result.
Opposite. All will be very unhappy. Upadrata, always so many kinds of
disturbances.
They can fix thereby. What to do? You know all these things. Ata sadho, ata jatsaram, samudhitya manishaya, bruhitanme, saddadanam jena atma samprasi. You know everything from your Guru Sukadeva Goswami, that Badarayan Krishna Dvaipayan Ved Vyasa has done. And that books you have read from your Gurudev, you have heard. The essence of all the Vedic literature you have heard. So you know all the things. So now, for us, we are Sadhalu.
Faithful person.
Faithful person. Towards whom? Krishna. So please, what is the essence of all the literature and all the classes of your Gurudev and others that you have heard from Narada, Vyas and others, you should tell us. Jayatma samprasidati. By that practicing, our soul will be satisfied. Our soul will be happy. Now in this world, those who are not devotee are even Kanishtha Adhikari, they are not happy. Even. Only beginning from Madhyam Adhikari, Madhyam, they can realize something and they can be happy. Otherwise, no one in this world is happy. So he asked and then he became very happy. And then he began to speak what he has heard from Guru. Sutta Grihitaya. What meaning? What he has heard from his Gurudev by serving him, by questioning him very honorably. And what he has realized, he began to tell. Savai punsang paro dharmo jato bhakti radho khaje ahetukya vyavahita ja bhakti purushottami. Oh, what was the question? How our soul will be happy and satisfied? So he is telling, Sabain, oh surely and surely and surely. If we will follow Param Dharma, and what is that Param Dharma? Param Dharma is the highest topic of religious. That is Swadharma, transcendental religion. And what that bhakti adhokshaja? Adhokshaja means Krishna. Who Krishna? Nrisimhadev, Vamandev, who? Rakesh, who? Brajendra Nandan Shyam Sundar Khe Krishna Karuna Sindhu Deenabandho Jagatpate Gopesh Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Brajendra Nandan Gopisha, the most beloved of all the gopis, especially of Srimati Radhika, that Hari Krishna, His Supreme Lord, Swayam Bhagavan. In the end, after that, it will be established. So, bhakti of Krishna, ahetuka prahatihata, causeless. And apratihata, like honey, continuous, like honey,
unbroken
stream of honey.
And by this, Atma will supersede the Atma, surely, by nishchitrupena, what?
Sure and certain.
Soul will be held. So I have come to remind all these things. Don't always remember two slokas, one of Gita and one of Srimad Bhagavatam. Tattenu kampam susamekshamano bhunjale evatmakritam vipaham. Hrita-pāka-patu-vedyu-dhatan-namaste jīvekta-jama-mukti-padeśa-tāyakā. What sufferings are coming? Anyone cannot give any kind of disturbance or any kinds of what?
Suffering, distress.
Anyone is not responsible. Who is responsible? You. Yourself. Your activities, bad activities of past lives. If it is coming, try to tolerate. But thinking that this is the mercy of Krishna. If anyone causing us like Parikshit Maharaj, what is thought? Oh Krishna, mercy has come. So many pure souls like Sukadeva Goswami, Narada, Vyas, Pula, Pulastha, Gautam, all came in a moment. Where is cause? Don't blame anyone that he is the root.
Root of all evil.
Lila Sukh is the root. No. Any other is root. Brajavalla Prabhu is the root of all evils. So don't think, then you will be happy. Dukhesu anudignamana. Sukhesu bigat spriha. Bita ragbhaya krodha sthiti muni uchyate. Dukhesu anudignamana. Don't be disturbed when sufferings are coming. Be very bold. And Sukhesu bigat prisha. Don't have any ambition of being happy. What Krishna is giving? Just so tolerate. And think mercy. Be tarag bhai krodha. You should give up your fear or attachment to worldly things, to son, wife, husband, children, position, any money. Don't. We have not come or taken from your boyhood, from your own, after your mother. Have you brought anything? If in this world you are losing something,
what, how?
Krishna has given.
He has taken that.
We have not come from heavenly planet or any place. Golok Vrindavan. Why? Why you are anxious so much? You cannot do anything in this world. Whether in you want or not, Maya will not test it for you. Old age will come very, very soon, running. and death will come. Then all the things what you have collected, position, money, everything, or son, daughter, nephew, and others, will have to be. Where to go, you don't know. If you are not doing bhajan, you will be animals like hogs, pigs, and others will cut and take you. So, be careful. So, we should know, he has told Sutta Goswami, Bhaktir Adhokhaje. We know the meaning of Adhokshaj Krishna. And especially Brijendranandan Shyam Sundar, Radha Kant, Gopi Balla. We know this, Adhokshaj. But what is Bhakti? We should know. Bhakti is very vyapak.
Very vast.
Oh, all pervading.
Huh?
All pervading.
All pervading. From Shraddha, last fraction, and up to Madanakya Mahabhava. But there is gradation of bhakti. As higher Vaishnava are, their bhakti will be more superior. Dhruva as bhakta, Pralad was bhakta, Ambarish Maharaj was bhakta, Hanuman was bhakta, Pandavar were bhakta, Uddhava was bhakta. Are they in one category? After those who are not bhakta, they are Kaya view of Krishna and Radhika. Sridham Subal, Nanda Baba Jasoda and others, gopis, all the gopis under the guidance of Rupmanjari, all are bhakta. But are they same? No.
No, never.
Even you should know that the bhakti of Dhruva Maharaj was bhakti but not pure. Pralad Maharaj pure but mixed with
Jigyan.
Hanuman, but was lacking some thang brishambha.
Intimacy.
Pandaval, more superior, but lacking something. And Uddhava. Oh, he was like Krishna. He was more dear than soul, even Brahma, Shankar,
Lakshmi,
even from Balaram, even he was most dear of Krishna. But Uddhava could not find the end of the gopis' love and affection. Sima, what?
Limit.
Limit
and bottom.
And gopi has how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Unlimited. Millions and millions of gopis are.
Billions.
And their all moods are different. So we want to explain something for bhakti. And you should. I have told so many times, but again I am remembering.
Kirtan.
So you should try to know what is real bhakti and then try to practice. First you should
establish
your
goal
of the life, goal of your devotion. What you want? Do you want to be Rukmini or the Dasija of Rukmini? Or you want to be like Sita? Do you want to be Hanuman, always serving? Do you want to be like Uddhava? Then what is remaining? Uddhava? You want to be like Uddhava?
Yes.
You don't know.
You want to meet Uddhava? Very good. You want to be Lalita Vishakhad Gan Sakhi? You? What you want?
Padam Jayo Padam Yaskabina Baradasama Ivan and Yakada Visamaya Kiladeya.
This is awesome. Don't go to talk. Don't think I'm goofy. Come down from the level of Shraddha and practice from Shraddha. What is bhakti? Rupa Goswami has discovered from all Shastra and what he heard from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He made a paribhasha, definition of bhakti. In Srimad Bhagavat Vidik, we see lakshana hi jo bhakti yogasya nirgunasya udahritam ahetu kya abhyavahita ja bhakti same as here savai punsang paro dharma. In other Narada Rishi, Sandilya Rishi, they have fixed the definition of bhakti. Sab upadhi binirmuktam tat parataina nirbalam. Sri Kesha. And Sandilya?
Sa paranurakti.
It covers all the definition in Deshanna, Virasita, Sunya. Jnana karma yana vrita anukullena krishna anukshitiyana bhakti ruttama. Try to remember this definition. And according to definition you should try to follow Krishna bhakti. Very soon you will be like, you should explain. In a good way. Where is my?
Om Jnana Timarandasa Jnananjana Salakya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. So Srila Gurudev ordered me to speak a few words to elaborate on the meaning of the definition of transcendental
what
devotion.
Vishwanath Chakrabarti Thakur had told in Bhakti Rasami Sindhu Bindi, you should try to fully.
So on the order of Gurudev, I'll try to comment on the explanation of this verse of Srila Rupa Goswami.
If anyone is not understanding, any question they can put up.
And we'll do this following the explanation given by Srila Vishwanath Chakrabarti Thakur in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindu. So first of all, Srila Rupa Goswami Pad has given the definition by the inspiration of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anya vilashita shunyam jnana kamadyanabritam anukulyena krishnanu shilanam bhakti uttama. Our first level of understanding is the general translation. What is that? The continuous, uninterrupted cultivation of all endeavors of our body, of our mind, of our words, and of sentiments of the heart, which is meant exclusively for the benefit of Krishna, which is completely devoid of even the slightest smell of any other desire, which is not covered by karma, fruitive activity, jnana, the cultivation of knowledge to attain liberation, yoga, the development of mystic power, and dry austerities and other things. That very continuous cultivation, which is performed under the guidance of Shuddha Vaishnava, of pure devotee of the Lord,